why I play harder. Can you hear yourself when you play harder? No. No. So you have to talk to yourself and staying relaxed. All those years with the banjo standing right next to me. And finally Keith Bauman said to me one day, he said, lean over your guitar with it. So I went like this, and my guitar was about 3 times as loud. And all I did was that. All of a sudden I could hear myself. But then when I heard myself trying to play really hard, repetition is how we learn how to do this stuff. And I was learning how to sound really terrible. Really terrible. I mean, Dan Prairie plays loud and how he does it. Doc really didn't play loud, although he eventually plugged in. Rice used to dig in really hard. But if you notice, when Rice was playing, he looked like a drum beat. No stress. No tension. He was relaxed. I love that video of, I think they called it the Tony Rice All-Stars at World Fest, 1985 or so. Easy to find on YouTube. But you watch these guys, you know, they're the young guns, and Baylor's just almost asleep. Rice is relaxed as he can be. O'Connor's just like, meditate. And you're hearing the most incredible music coming from the music. And that really is the key. Relax. Relax and breathe. The guy told me once, you were sounding great, man, until you turned blue. Because I used to go, you know, I was swinging a sledge. It's just a guitar or a mandolin or a banjo.
Yeah, I play a banjo in a jam when I get there.
You're a pleasure. You're a pleasure. I stood next to a banjo for 2.5 years. It's still ringing in my ears.
Well, you should in the jam slow down a little bit. Some people just
You know, the jams are a whole different story. Rarely do you play in a jam where something goes kind of performance speed. Most of the reason for going to a jam is meeting people, but learning the music, or learning how to play the music. And again, learning the music fast just teaches you how to play it fast and not very good. So starting slow. If you're going to achieve speed on the guitar, because you want to play fast just as much as you have to do it. Muscle memory is the key. Repetition is how we develop that. And if we develop it with a nice, loose wrist, breathing, free shoulders, even meditating, and I meditate a lot on this day. Just tuning out. Well, it's the human part of me that wants to get nervous, wants to get a little shaky. It's the human part of me that goes, oh crap, there's 200 people. That's all the human part. The spiritual part of me says, come on, boy, let's go. I got this. So, yeah, meditating. Where I take my human that I'm following, better chance I have. I mean, I need to get to do the part of the out of balance of the check. Let alone playing well. But that's how I developed. And then you can go on into things like hammer-ons and slides and pull-offs, which help. You know? I don't know, this blue chip pick is a 55. Well, that's not a measurement like normal picks. I think it's about a 1.2 or 1.25. are, some of them aren't very well, so they can see that. I don't promote Blue Chip for money. Well, he needs to pony up. Because I'll tell you, I've spent hundreds of dollars on tortoiseshell, fake tortoiseshell, bullhorn, fake bullhorn tortoiseshell / rhino tusk, you know, you name it, I've spent a lot of money on it. And for $35, this pig comes with a bevel already cut. It does not wear. It doesn't need to be dressed or sanded ever, in my experience. And as long as you don't lose them, if I quit losing mine, I think these would last me as long as I'm able to play. They do not wear. And this is a Chris Thiele 55.
You had something to do.
We were on our way home from Colorado, and I'd already lost like 3 or 4 pigs. So a lot of pigs were in Marshall and Iowa before we get back to Chicago. And I say, dang, I'm out of pigs. And Grant says, hey, I've got this one, and I gave it to him. You want to try this? So I did, and I've been playing this big triangle mandolin pig ever since. The best tone of any pick I've ever used, and it just doesn't wear out. And I haven't put my problem on it, but it feels like about a 1-2 or 1-2-5. Of course, if you go to Steve Coffin's workshop, he'll tell you that playing that pick isn't a great idea, but Steve plays a 0.73, and nobody does that.
How important do you think it is to learn the pentatonic scales?
Important is it to learn the pentatonic scales? I think it's important as an exercise to work your fingers. I think it's important as an exercise to train your ears. I think it's important as an exercise to get this in sync. And then you kind of have to forget it. Same with the major scale, though.
Yeah.
Same with the major scale, because what we want to play are phrases. We want to play phrases, not scales. Now, when I was playing electric guitar and playing country music, you know, I'd still copy the fiddles and the steel guitars. But this guitar, once I started learning fiddle tunes, I started learning phrases. I started learning real, beautiful, vocal, like, phrases. So fiddle tunes was what really helped me build a repertoire of phrases and learning how to play over scale chord progressions. I think there's importance in learning the scales. Once you have the muscle memory to do them, then you kind of have to let them go. Yeah. We'll start learning finitudes, or start copying vocal lines.
Kind of
improvise. That's a crazy story. This isn't bluegrass oriented, this isn't guitar oriented. Warren Haynes from the Allman Brothers, when he was young, was copying Wilson Pickett vocal phrases. Like Dionne Warwick vocal phrases, which was how he developed his toolbox, so to speak, phrases to use.
Can
I help you with my phrase?
Well, I'm having trouble with my finger. I think that voice is too hard. Relax.
Here's a million-dollar question. Will it sound better if you press on it? No, it really won't. It really won't. But we're Westerners through and through. I don't know about you guys. If I told my dad something was working on, he'd say, hit it harder. Get a bigger stick. Get a bigger hammer. Something. Yeah. And the guitar just kind of laughs at that kind of stuff. You know, it truly does. Imagine the bench was the same. My experience is if I start clapping out of that banjo, everything falls apart. just won't play. Same with band. How hard do I hope they pick? Do they sound better if I squeeze it tight? Not at all. I just don't want to drop it. That's all. If I do drop it, squeeze it just a little bit harder. So, you know, the harder I work at this, well, some guys use that stuff. Another thing about the blue check, the saliva, and that thing won't go anywhere.
Is that the brand?
Yes, the brand is Blue Chip. I think you can buy them in maybe two or three stores nationwide. Buy them online from the company direct. Put a little bit of saliva, and that fixes right with it. I don't know what this material is, but I hope they can build it.